My name is EeplesVox, and today I'll be showing you how to set up live streaming for a few different platforms in the Elgato Game Capture HD software. I will have other tutorials on Elgato's capture cards and a plethora of other technology topics on my channel, so be sure to subscribe if you found this video helpful, and check the YouTube card icon above or the description below for a playlist with my other Elgato gaming related videos. Why bother with third-party streaming programs when the Elgato Game Capture software can do it all for you? Check out my video on the stream command functionality to see all the tools available to you, but let's go ahead and set up a live streaming profile or two to get you going. To set up live streaming, find the live streaming box in the right sidebar of the Game Capture software. By default, it should say no accounts. Click the little plus symbol next to that and choose your desired streaming platform. YouTube, Twitch, Ustream, Facebook, and Dailymotion are supported with direct tools within the software, but you can choose the custom RTMP option and stream to just about any platform on the internet. Let's walk through setting up a few popular choices. If you want to stream to Twitch, select the Twitch account choice. This will pop up a box for you to log into Twitch, and then it will automatically access the stream. Now you can adjust the bitrate on the left, change your stream title, and once you type in a new title, click the arrow in that box to send the update to Twitch. The same arrow now also appears next to the game name box under tags at the bottom. Change the game name and click the arrow to change your game on Twitch. It's that simple. Click the gear icon next to your stream title to access advanced settings. Here you can manually select a server to stream to, based on ping, choose a maximum resolution and frame rate to stream at, you'll want to set this low if you don't have a fast upload speed, and choose whether or not you want to save a copy of the streamed video file. This is useful for re-uploading the stream video to another platform or just keeping an archive. Most Elgato cards will record the master copy when you use the main record button, which is why the stream copy box is necessary. Once your settings are solid, click the green stream button at the bottom and have fun. To stream to YouTube, click the YouTube account option instead. This will prompt you to log in with your Google account. It does support two-factor authentication, by the way. Log in and choose your desired YouTube channel. You can add multiple channels from one account or multiple Google accounts to the software. Then you can choose which channel you stream to via the drop-down menu. Now you also have a new settings button next to the channel name. Clicking that will let you set up a live event on YouTube. Not setting up a live event will just use the Stream Now beta on YouTube. Using the Live Stream Manager on YouTube gives you the most control over your stream title and game name versus the Stream Now beta. But also just keep in mind that you cannot push live updates of these titles to YouTube from the software like you can with Twitch. You'll have to use YouTube's Live Stream Manager. Clicking the settings gear icon once again lets you customize server selection, resolution, and frame rate, but now you can also change the privacy of the live stream from public, unlisted, or private, and the category. If you're not streaming a game and don't want to be on YouTube gaming, you can change the category to something else. Once again, set up your settings, change your bitrate, and hit stream, and you're good to go. Streaming to Facebook from anything but a mobile device used to be a complicated process, but not anymore, at least for Facebook profiles. In the latest 3.5 update to the Game Capture HD software, Facebook is now a dedicated platform choice to stream to. Again, for your Facebook profile, not a fan page. To add your Facebook profile, click the plus again and add a new live streaming account and choose Facebook. Log in with your Facebook account information and hit OK. Now you're good to go to start streaming. If you want to stream to your Facebook fan page, however, it is a tad bit more complicated. Go to your Facebook fan page and click on Publishing Tools, then click on the Video section on the left-hand sidebar. Now, over on the right, there should be a plus live button. Here you can get the stream URL and the stream key to paste into the Elgato software. This will allow you to stream to your page. For Facebook, the key is only valid for 7 days, and you will have to start your stream within 5 hours of creating this key, or you'll have to start all over. This is an annoyance, but one you can work with. But again, make sure no one sees your stream key ever. The stream key allows someone to stream to your page on any platform, Twitch, Facebook, YouTube, anything. So make sure no one ever sees your key, or you need to reset it. If you wish to stream to another streaming platform, you will need to choose the RTMP option and set up a custom profile. For this, I will be using Restream.io, a service designed to let you stream to multiple sites at once. I'm doing this as an easy example, but keep in mind that Elgato has recently added a Restream as a dedicated platform choice in the software. So for Restream specifically, you don't actually have to do this. This is just an easy option to show you how to add custom sites. Once you've clicked RTMP, give the profile a name, such as Restream or Hitbox or Live Sportscaster. Then copy over your RTMP URL and stream key from the platform into the boxes and hit Add. This profile now shows up by name with custom RTMP in parentheses added to the end. Again, never show your stream key for any site to anyone. If that happens, if you show it on a stream or in a video, reset it immediately. But that's it. This has been a fairly lengthy tutorial compared to the others, but I wanted to make sure all the bases were covered when it came to live streaming. If you want to know how to actually manage your live stream scenes and various tools available to you, check out my previous videos in the playlist. I covered the stream command, adding live commentary, just about everything. I hope this video has been helpful for you. If it has, use Hyperbeam on that like button, get subscribed for more awesome tech videos, and check out the description down below. There I have a link to the playlist with all of my Elgato gaming tutorials and reviews. Check them out. I also have product links to each Elgato card if you're looking to buy one, and I'll see you in the next video. Thank you so much for watching.